In this week's episode on Living Free Alaska, Stacy takes you along on a 90-mile snow machine ride to a remote backcountry lodge on an overnight ladies' adventure while I stay at home following my knee surgery.
And I fill you in on my time volunteering at the 2024 Arctic Winter Games, as well as show you how spring is shaping up around the homestead and how Gary is really handling his recovery 2 weeks post-surgery.
In 2020, we made the huge decision to sell our home in the lower 48 and move north to Alaska to live a way of life free from the hustle and bustle of big city life. Join us here as we share our everyday adventures living free in Alaska. Iditarod, and I am now on a ladies' ride with 32 other women, so there's 33 of us total. We're riding to a remote lodge, so we've got quite the party going on. And this is one third of the way, so we're about 30 miles into our ride, and we got about 100 to go. So it's a great start. It's a beautiful day. It's warm. Warm meeting like 20, and the sun is shining, so can't complain. Okay, what do you think so far?
Oh, this is awesome.
How's being in the back?
Oh, well, I get to play a little bit.
Yeah. Very cool.
I kind of go off on my own.
There you go.
As long as I got my girl in my sight.
Right? how do girls like that hill?
I liked it. It was so fun. Cool. I swear to God, Lisa, she did so good.
So this is Lisa's second time ever riding.
I was on one for about, 20 minutes yesterday? Half hour?
I didn't want today to be my very first time.
All right.
Yeah, it was awesome.
All right.
So awesome.
A little different from last Sunday out here,
yes,
huh?
Yes, it is.
I wish we had the sun last weekend.
I agree.
All right.
This is stunning.
So good.
All right, well, I think it's time to gear up. It's time to gear back up and get ready to ride and continue up the Yetna River up to Yetna Station. That's our next big stop. Made it to our next stop. We are at the Yetna Station, and we're about 30 miles downriver of where we're going to be ending our ride today and staying the night. So I got my fur on, and we're going to go up and maybe order a beer.
We'll be right back.
We have made it to the Squintna Roadhouse. We're just lined up waiting to refuel our machines. So when we go to leave in the morning, we don't have to take care of that and we can just go. My machine did better than I thought it would. I'm just under a half a tank. So I'm pleased with that. I was worried I was gonna run out just one way. So, all right, we are here. It's time to relax, unwind, and have some fun. Another excellent adventure with Bill. Today we are at the Yetna station, about 34 miles up the Iditarod Trail. And we were here last week downriver a ways at Scary Tree. So he is for sure gonna see this backcountry of Alaska. So, Bill, you'll have to wait here until spring, but then your journey will begin. All right, you ready?
I'm ready.
We don't want to get anyone. All right, let's do this differently. There he goes. He's on my machine. That's okay. All right, Felicia. Release number 2 is in the books.
And Bill spent the night with all these lovely ladies last night.
All right. Until next adventure. Well, I was unsure if my sandwich was gonna be good, but it's okay. It passes. And the birthday boy got dressed.
I've always been dressed.
He's hooking himself back up to his ice machine.
Yep, and lugging the leg. There it is.
Oh, I had PT today, so. I came home from PT and put my ice wrap on, but I've also put an ace bandage and I have my brace on as well. Just because I have to have the brace on to go anywhere, to walk around, to move. I gotta keep my legs straight. But after PT, I put the ice pack on and that helps a lot. And I'm just gonna kind of hang out with the ice pack and the brace on for a little bit and eat some lunch. I think I've got pretty awesome looking grilled cheese sandwich here.
So. Nothing fancy. I did my best.
Looking forward to it. It looks great, and I'm sure it's gonna be great.
Homemade sourdough bread.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Lots of butter.
Lots of butter. Lots of cheese. Goodness, goodness. Thank you. Mm. Yeah, memorable 51. Woohoo!
I want to say thank you to all the wonderful birthday messages we've received on Facebook and on YouTube and Instagram. All the socials. Gary is getting the love both here at home and from you guys.
Even State Farm.
Yeah. Our State Farm agent just called to wish Gary a happy birthday. That was all.
God.
Just shows you how they do things differently up here.
Yep.
All right, well, we're gonna eat our lunch and then I'm gonna come back to you this afternoon when it's time to do our pizza. So,
oh, yeah.
Gary's just hanging out on the couch watching television.
This is what I'm supposed to do. I don't like it. It's hard. It's difficult for me to do. Yeah.
Well, Well, and today I'm actually home with them. Tomorrow I start my volunteering job with the Arctic Winter Games, so I'll be gone tomorrow afternoon. And then I get Wednesday with him again, and then I'm gone Thursday, Friday. So he's learning to do well without me. He can get by.
It's much easier with somebody here to help. I can I can get a little bit of stuff to me and, you know, drinks and such, but it's... I've got to shuffle and slide and shuffle and slide.
He's found how to slide from the counter to the dining room table to his end table, so.
Yeah, so long as there's not much stuff in there. Which Stacey has a tenant seat in.
Oh, put stuff in the way. Whatever. All right, we're going to eat our lunch, yep. And we'll check in a little bit. Well, I'm not going to lie. I had some troubles, so I did not record the part of rolling out the dough. This is all new to me, and I'm still learning, and I was having problems with it sticking to the board, and Carrie just says, why don't you use parchment paper? Duh! So, I am now going to build the pizza. And I'm gonna get the oven going, and we're gonna pop it in. And I will show you the final product here once I'm done building.
View on this side of the car, something different. Kind of like it though. Getting driven around, little chauffeur status going on right now. It's kind of nice. So this is kind of my first outing since my surgery, and Stacy's driving us down to the Menard Center today so we can partake in the closing ceremonies of the Arctic Winter Games that Stacy's been volunteering for last week.
Oh, yeah.
She's had several positions. She's done some cross-country skiing photography as well as basketball. And she's also been a, is it a host or a
hospitality lounge host.
There you go. So she's been busy with them Arctic Winter Games and trying to take care of me. Whoops. So yeah, this is my first day out.
Yes. I'm first out, other than going to physical therapy.
I don't count that as a day out because that's physical pain therapy.
Right.
Well, it's not painful, but...
Well, and you haven't done... You've gone to physical therapy and straight home.
Yeah, yeah. So this one, we're going to go to the Arctic Winter closing games and then probably out to dinner afterward. And I'm looking forward to getting out, not being tied to the house. That's going to be kind of nice. Although crutching around town's a little difficult. Got to watch out for the icy spots and this and that, but... We're here, it's mid-March now, and well, the current temperature is 32 right here, so it's not too cold at all. A few days ago, we had temperatures in the 40s.
Almost all week.
Almost all week, so there's been a lot of melting going on, so parking lots and such are basically clear of snow and ice, so shouldn't be worried about too much of that.
I got a new rock chip on the windshield.
Oh, I see it down there.
Yeah. It happened right here.
Wow. Mm.
Spring.
Yep,
I think the car is going to get a new windshield.
Well, I'm going to
this summer.
Yep.
Got to get through spring first.
So we got a nice big rock chip there. That's been there for a while. New rock chip is, I'm not sure if you can see it, but it's right down there. And then of course we got the big old crack in the window.
It's been there.
It goes all the way across several directions.
Down below.
So, you know, you're very familiar with this view in the past from when we've done road trip views. So we're going to try to get that replaced here pretty soon so you don't have to look through our cracks.
It's just an Alaska thing.
Right. You go every couple years to replace your windshield just because you're going to get real good.
So I had an absolutely amazing fun time volunteering
with the Arctic Winter Games. I will definitely say I am not a photographer. I am a hobbyist photographer. And I definitely excel better at videography, but I gave it my all. Originally, when I decided to help in this department on the media team, I thought I'd get Gary to help with editing. But I actually did it all myself.
You did, yeah.
So, and I feel I did pretty good. It was really nice. Working the hospitality lounge, I had downtime because I worked the evenings and it wasn't as busy. So I could do all my editing while I was still at the games, which was super nice. So I could come home and actually go straight to bed and then wake up and do it all over again. And if you can't tell, I've got some pretty big bags underneath my eyes.
It's been a busy couple of weeks for her.
Well, I haven't. This has been really like a full-time job.
Right. And well, and not just the Arctic Winter Games, but everything else you've had going on this last month.
Taking care of you, going on my snow machine trip.
Living Free Alaska's daily videos.
Ooh, that wiped me out.
Challenge.
And that was all in February. And then we went straight into the games. And boy, I haven't caught a break.
Yeah.
But, and even still, I've got to jump straight into spring's almost here. So
right.
I've got my rally, I've got a plan. I still have my RV into Alaska business I got to take care of. So.
Me too. I knew this was going to be tough on both of us. I've had a little bit of conflicting information that I have since verified one way or the other, and
on
my treatment and my plan forward with what I can do. So with this surgery that I had, it's a complicated surgery, and I am to be fully non-weight bearing on this leg for 6 weeks. That seems like a long time. It seems like kind of crazy therapy. But the way the surgery was done, the bone has to heal the suture in to hold the root of my meniscus down, kind of thing. My doctor, my surgeon, wants me fully non-weight bearing for the total 6 weeks. So it's a big deal.
We're only on week two.
We're into week two right now. Just hit week two on Monday. So,
Well, you've gone through two full weeks.
Yeah. So, it's tough. And I didn't, you know, reading some of the therapy things previous to surgery, I was hearing, you know, well, we can, you know, put 20% pressure on your weight, on your leg, and this and that, and just weight transfer. But no, it basically, if I can crack an egg on my foot, that's almost too much weight to be bearing on my leg.
And your therapist was working you harder than you were supposed to, because he didn't understand your plan.
The therapist was kind of on a wrong plan as well. So we got everybody on the right track now, and it's going to be a little bit more difficult of a recovery just because of the non-weight bearing issue. So I will be on crutches for a solid month still.
Four more weeks.
And I guess that's going to build up my upper body strength a little bit, huh?
You are crutching around a little better.
I'm crutching around pretty good. I do have to say, though, I think I am also already experiencing some muscular atrophy in my right leg, specifically my calf. It seems to be losing a little bit of muscular structure, which is very normal and expected. It's just unfortunate. And that's what physical therapy is going to do for me. It's going to help build that back. So it won't be such a challenge once I am able to walk and exercise again. So that's a little update on me. We're about to pull into the Menard Center, so we're going to change view up a little bit.
Welcome to Nunavut!
just for winning some medals, but for participating from the beginning. I want to thank all the sponsors, all the coaches, all the chaperones. I want to thank the folks here in Wasilla for putting this on and working with folks here across the northern part of North America and into Europe.
Have room to grow as the seasons show. All that is to come in the midnight sun.
Make some noise for the game!
Well, good morning. Today's Monday the 18th, and Mondays are physical therapy days. So I'm just sitting here waiting for Gary to get through physical therapy. He's been up there for about a half an hour, so I still got a half an hour to go. So I thought I'd use this time and fill you in on what we've been doing. Pretty much nothing. Well, at least Gary. Poor Gary. I have to give it to him. That boy does not know how to sit and do nothing. And that is all he has done for the past 2 weeks. So his surgery was 2 weeks ago today. Tomorrow we actually come back here and meet with his surgeon for his 2 week post-op follow-up. So it seems like constantly running into town. But Gary's doing pretty good. He's crutching around the house. He still asks me to do a lot of things, and I'll admit I roll my eyes half the time, but yes, I'm doing my best in helping him with his recovery. But he's doing pretty well on his own as well. He's found ways to move things from the kitchen to his chair. Of course, he's got to get up and go to the bathroom on his own, and I help him get dressed and all that good stuff. For the first week, he slept on the couch. Now he's sleeping back with me in our bedroom at night, so I like that. I don't think I slept as well with him being out in the living room. All last week, I was super busy with Arctic Winter Games. I had such a good time with that. I am exhausted from it, though. I spread my shifts out pretty well to give me some breaks, which was nice. It all started with Tuesday. I shot cross-country skiing.
Two alternates, up and over the hill, down to the finish line.
Go, 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 hard, 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 Kelly. Hard, hard, hard.
And folks, we have 5 minutes. It's our next race, 5.
Well, welcome to Government Peak Recreation Area, and we are at the cross-country races here at the Arctic Winter Games. And currently I am on, actually, I don't know if you can see them right back there, they're climbing up a hill, which is called the waterfall as they go down. And then they'll be zipping across here. Right now we've got the boys going, an older age group. And of course, when they're going by, I have to film, I have to shoot. But I'll turn the camera around and see if I can get them as they're zipping by. So they're doing 2 laps, so they're going to come back up this hill for a second lap here in a few minutes. Thank you.
And that was really amazing to watch. You know, when I first picked that, I thought, well, one, everyone was telling me you need to do something outdoors. So I chose cross country skiing because I thought, oh, that's nice and easy. It's flat ground. I can get around the course really well. I learned really quick that, holy crud, they have hills in cross country. I got a workout that day and I need it. But I had a blast trudging up and down the hills and catching both the boys and girls cross country meets for cross country skiing. It was truly amazing to watch. There were some really good races and I'm really happy with my photos that I took. Then on Thursday and Friday, I had two really big days, 9.5 hours each of volunteering. The first half was doing photography for basketball, and each shift I caught at least two games. On the first day, I actually did a third game, but I could only do one quarter because I had to move on to my second job. And then on day two of basketball, I got to do the medal game. So I did the bronze boys game and then the gold medal game for the girls. And then in the evenings, my shift switched to a hospitality host. And I basically worked in the volunteer lounge. And I just made sure that the food was stocked, that it was clean, that everyone had a comfortable place to come and take a break. So that was a lot of fun. So that was my week last week. Crazy. Between the women's ride to Squintna last weekend and then going straight into the games. I definitely sat on the couch all day yesterday with my husband, but it was great because we're all caught up with our real-time or with our catch-up videos, and I got our first real-time video done from February, edited and uploaded, and that actually went live today. So that's what I've been up to. Other than that, we do not have much going on. I'm actually looking forward to that. Between all my editing in February, my household chores really lacked. So I've got to get caught up on laundry and I've got to do some deep cleaning. Spirit, I mean, it's spring. It's hard to believe it's spring. It did snow today, but it's like 40. It's been 40 degrees the last couple of days. But Spirit is shedding, so as you can imagine with a husky, we have hair everywhere. And so I need to do a really good deep clean. And with that, shampoo carpets and mop floors. I mean, it's just time. It's spring. Spring's in the air. We probably still, what is it, March 18th. We probably have a good 6 weeks yet until it truly feels like spring and looks like spring. But this is what we call breakup season. And this is when the mud really starts showing up and things can get really dirty really fast. So that is my goal. And we're going to just try to bring you some more content. I'm going to do some sourdough bread cooking content, I believe. And whatever else we can think of. Content's going to be a little light until Gary's back on his feet, but we'll keep bringing what we can bring to you. Well, happy first day
of spring 2024. Doesn't really look like spring, does it? Today is March 19th, and I didn't realize this. I just happened to be writing on my calendar, and it said today was the first day of spring. And I Googled it, and sure enough, at 2:06 in the afternoon, Alaska time, was officially the start of spring. So I guess because we are in a leap year, spring is one day early. So who knew? I thought I'd come outside, try to find any sign of spring, and well, I'm not finding it. Other than it's like 42 degrees, it's beautiful. Rusty is squawking up something fierce. That's just because I'm outside. He likes to talk when he knows his humans are around. The only other way that I can probably say it's spring is our roof is melting, and we actually, turn it around, have some bare spots in the yard where the dirt is showing. So that's a start. I mean, last year we had snow on the ground until May 10th. That's when the last of our snow piles melted off. So we're still, I hate to say it, 2 months out from that. But who knows? Maybe we'll have an early summer. That'd be great. Well, I just went and checked on the fluffy butts, and I got another egg. I already had 11 from this morning, so this makes number 12, a full dozen in one day. You can tell it's warmer. They're laying a lot more. But other than that, it's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. Gary's doing wonderful. He went and visited with the doctor, and let's go check in with him and get the progress report. I think it's time to sell some eggs. Welcome to Gary's Corner. Hi. How you feeling?
I got a double whammy going on right now.
And what do you mean by that?
Well, this, and a lot of limitations, and this now just decided to attach itself to me, as in a head cold, sinus pressure, and nasal congestion, and all that good fun stuff. Yes, loving life right now. Oh, the big squish. Big boob squish.
Ow, that's not nice. Well, as you can imagine, yes, it's a double whammy. Not only do I have to take care of him because of his knee, but now he's man sick.
That's just no fair.
Every wife knows what I'm talking about.
And every husband knows it goes the other way as well. So it's a two-way road with this one, baby. I had to deal with you a couple weeks ago, so.
I don't know, but I didn't have surgery dealing with that, too.
No.
So I was telling them it's first day of spring.
Happy spring. Woohoo! Yay.
I'm looking out at the thermometer. It looks like it's around 42 degrees.
Yeah.
It's above that 40. It's very nice. But you went to the doctor today.
Yep. More of the same.
It was more positive than that. Oh, but more of the same of just sitting here and doing nothing.
Yes. He said, you're doing great. Keep it up for another 4 weeks. So, yeah, he said more of the same. Everything's fine. They took the stitches out.
He also gave you the okay to not wear the brace 24/7.
Right. And that's, I kind of knew that was coming, which is good. I was looking forward to that. I still like to have it on just in case there's a slip up on the crutches and such when I'm crutching around.
Especially if he's outside.
Yeah.
Still icy out.
I don't want to mess it up, you know? I want to kind of try to do it right, even though this is driving me crazy. I want to try to do this right.
We are both packing our patience with this.
Yes.
But
He's doing pretty good. He's crossing his legs.
Yep, there's a bad one.
Yep, there's his. He's still a little swollen, but we're handling well, and he's surviving with my cooking.
Oh, your cooking's been great. It's been fine. Minimal, but it's been fine.
Whatever. He does have to urge me every once in a while. Like, are you gonna feed me?
And you know, I don't like to. I really don't like to poke the bear and all that. And you know, I really only try to ask when I see her. I don't like, hey, Stacy, come help me. I don't do that. You know, because I do value my life. So, you know, I only when she makes an appearance in the living room like three times a day, I'll ask for help.
That's not true. All right. Well, I just wanted to do a quick little update. Yep. I know everyone's been asking and wanted to put it into real time when this video goes up. Oh, so
sounds good.
All right. I will let you get back to your TV shows and your YouTube.
I had to cut my own cheese. I had to reach up really high on the shelf with my own crackers.
He doesn't ask. He just goes and does.
I don't want to poke the bear.
Lordy.
She needs a thing, right?
Yeah. All right. Have fun. I'm not going to kiss you. I don't need your cooties.
No, you don't want it. Okay.
Okay. I'm going to go back to
work. Sounds good. Take care.
Thanks again for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you are notified whenever we post again. And lastly, we hope that you will join us here next time on Living Free Alaska.